I still can get no answer from Mr. Clearmer.
I'll try myself, Mary.
Playing seemed better than usual. A most delightful evening.
Well, but Clement, he hasn't missed one of these weekly sessions for years.
Oh, I'm quite sure he'll find some simple explanation.
He telephoned me earlier today. Said he had something he wanted to discuss with me after tonight's session.
Well, I guess I better be running along now. Thank you very much for your hospitality.
Oh, not at all, sir.
I was hoping we might get a chance to talk tonight.
On evenings like these, I'm afraid I prefer chamber music to conversation.
Good night.
Good night, Mr. Loftus.
Oh, there's still no reply from Mr. Clearmer, Father.
I've got an idea your father doesn't like me.
Oh, he'll warm up once he gets to know you.
Well, let's hope he warms up before we're married. Thank you, Mary. Thank you. Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
Is Mrs. Saville in? I'm Detective Inspector Holloway. I think I can see him for a moment.
Yes, come in, Inspector.
Reinhard Clearmer dead.
There's no doubt about the identification. His body was discovered in this alley shortly after 8 o'clock tonight.
Well, from what you say, it sounds like a hit-and-run accident.
Well, hardly an accident, Mr. Loftus. That car must have gone backwards and forwards over his body half a dozen times.
How did you know he was coming here, Inspector?
His landlady told us. He was carrying his violin case with him. Mr. Roth, might I ask you what you were doing at 8 o'clock this evening?
I had just come home from work. The rain in England, it chills me to the bone. And my wife made me take a hot bath, but it didn't help.
That's you.
Thank you.
And you, Mr. Ledoux?
I was not at home earlier this evening.
Huh?
There's a pub called the Blue Unicorn. I stopped by there for a drink on my way here. At the time of the murder, I was there.
I see. At the time of the murder, you said?
Yes, 8 o'clock.
And you, sir?
Me? I've got a witness. A policeman on the Great West Road.
Oh. Contravening our traffic regulations, huh? Speeding, was it?
Yeah, but note the time.
Oh, I noted the time, Mr. Loftus. 8 o'clock.
Is this really necessary, Inspector? Mr. Clearmer was our friend.
In that case, your information may be very helpful. Discovering who was his enemy. He was a solicitor, was he not?
Yes, yes, I was one of his clients. He handled my affairs for many years.
And where were you this evening, Miss Saville?
Here, in the house.
You didn't go out?
No.
And you, sir?
I went out for a while. But for your information, Inspector, since my heart attack a year ago, I'm not allowed to drive a car. I went for a walk. I was back home again by 8 o'clock, Mary will tell you. Mary?
The hall clock was striking just when Mr. Saville came in. It was exactly 8 o'clock.
Will that be all, Inspector?
Oh, yes. No more questions. thank you for your cooperation. But there's just one other thing. It's quite possible that all of you later on will have to make a formal statement.
But what for? You know where we were at 8 o'clock.
And that's true. Unfortunately, 8 o'clock was the time when Clermont's body was discovered. The medical report shows that the time of death was around 7. Good night. And God bless you.
We picked up the car this morning. The lab checked on the tire treads.
And what about the owner?
Well, he won't be much use to us. He's dead.
Dead?
Hmm. Died on the operating table yesterday afternoon. The car was pinched from the hospital car park. You're not safe anywhere nowadays.
Pity. I'm just performing an operation myself.
Who's the patient?
Your old friend, the late lamented Clammer. He's a bit of a mess.
You should have seen the original.
We've already run a few tests. No fingerprints.
Well, the clothing's all hand-sewn, of course.
Mm-hmm. Domestic wool. Could have come from any mill.
Hey, look at this, sir. Molded in wax with Clermont's features painted on.
Someone substituted a whole new head. But the body's ordinary enough. The manufacturer's imprint is usually right here.
Scraped off?
Yes.
You say that that body is a common mold?
Well, I bet 1,000 shops carry them in stock.
Well, you've learned all you can from that stuff.
Yes, I think so.
Put it together again, will you? I shall want it first thing in the morning.
It's like another case of looking for a needle in a haystack, sir.
That dog's our needle.
There's loads of haystacks.
You evidently haven't read the report on our friends.
Oh, nothing there, sir. Loftus is an American medical student. Ledoux's a sculptor. Roth works in the Dutch embassy. Savile's retired. And his daughter, Louise, she's a designer.
Yes. She designs dolls. She works in a toy shop. The face has been remodeled, of course. But we want to trace the manufacturers of the doll's body. I thought Miss Savile would recognize the make. She couldn't. But she thought that you might.
Oh, yes, this is the culprit. As I thought. You see, it's not just that they're the same size, but if you notice the hands, you'll see that they're absolutely identical.
Do you stock many of those?
Oh, no, sir. We discontinued this line a year ago. I'm afraid there isn't much call for this sort of thing now, you see. Today it's all bombs and rocket ships. Aggressive plastic and rather vindictive colours. Personally, I never want to sell anything you couldn't cuddle.
Quite. When did you last sell any of these?
Last? Oh dear, my memory is beginning to positively crumble. I should have to look that up.
I've already asked Gina to look it up. I found it. It was a couple of months ago.
Oh, there it is, yes. Exactly 2 months ago. Yes, 6 dolls.
6?
All delivered to the same address. 14 Ann Street, Mrs. Hedwig von Sturm.
14 Ann Street. Thank you very much indeed, sir.
Come in. I'm over here.
Mrs. von Sturm? I'm Detective Inspector Holloway.
Police?
Yes. I wondered if I might have a word with you.
Of course, I shall just close the door. I can manage, thank you.
Are you all alone here, Mrs. Von Stern?
I am never alone. Children, we have a visitor. This is Inspector Holloway. We were just having tea. Weren't we, meine Kinder? Will you join us?
Oh, no, thank you very much. You have a remarkable collection.
For 23 years, this has been my life. But you did not come here to talk about that.
No.
Let us go where we can have privacy. I shall be back in a moment. My workroom.
Do you make these dolls to sell?
Listen to him. I would not dream of selling my children. Ah, put down my little pupshin.
Mrs. Von Stern, did you ever make a doll like this?
Clever.
Do you recognize him?
Of course. Reinhard Klammer, my solicitor.
Did you make that doll?
No, Inspector. I did not make this.
Have you any idea who might have done?
No. Perhaps Mr. Klammer could tell you.
No. No, Klammer is dead.
Dead?
He was murdered yesterday. Brutally murdered. This doll was found by his body.
Oh, Mother! Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realize you had company.
This is Inspector Holloway. Inspector, my son, Mark.
How do you do?
You're from the police?
Mm. Mark, did you know that Reinhard Klammer is dead?
Yes, Mother. It was in the papers this morning.
Then why didn't you tell me?
I didn't want to upset you, Mother.
It's very important that I should know.
My mother's not very well. If you have any questions, perhaps I could help you.
Yes, perhaps you could. If you'll excuse us, Mrs. Von Stern.
No, Inspector. I've never seen this before. By new Klammer, of course.
Your mother says that he was her legal representative.
Yes, for my father's estate in Germany. It was confiscated after the war by an Allied commission. My father was an industrialist, and the commission claimed that he'd used slave labor in his factories. So they arrested him. He committed suicide in prison. My mother's always hoped to clear his name.
Well, Klammer was working on it for her.
Oh, he gave up ages ago. He never told Mother that. He said it was better to live in hope, and I agree with him. Her world collapsed when my father died, so she built a new one out of her own imagination.
Has she no friends?
She never leaves the house or invites anyone here. The dolls are her friends. The dolls and me.
Your mother said she didn't make this doll.
Well, is there any reason not to believe her?
She ordered half a dozen doll bodies of this type. Only a few months ago from the Regis toy shop.
Mother's always ordering doll bodies, see for yourself. She gets them from toy shops all over town.
Mr. Von Stern, where were you last night?
At my job. I'm a night watchman at the Moreland boatyard.
Night watchman?
My mother gives me food and lodging. I support myself.
Are you all alone at night in the boatyard?
Yes.
Then there's no one to vouch for your whereabouts at the time of the murder, is there?
No. No one.
Dear Inspector, how flattering you should wish to see my studio. I am honored.
Well, don't be. I'm here on official business.
You don't like my work? Neither do I. But it sells. It's Kramer you want to know about, isn't it?
I'm much more interested in the von Sturm family. What can you tell me about them?
Saville, Ruth, Kramer, and I, we were all members of an Allied commission in Germany after the war. We investigated war criminals. One of them was von Sturm. He claimed he was innocent, that one or more of us had falsified the evidence.
Why should any of you want to do that?
There were profits to be made in Germany after the war. Huge profits. When a man's property was confiscated, sometimes a portion of it disappeared.
If one of you were dishonest and Kramer found new evidence which would prove it, then there'd be a motive for his murder.
But none of us is. My work pays well. Ruth has his post at the embassy, and Savi has retired from a very good business.
I see. So you're all fairly well off. What about 20 years ago? This is a bit different from your usual work, isn't it?
I still do representational pieces just as a hobby. Please, sir, don't tell him. I want this to be a surprise.
It is. How many of these have you got?
Every artist has some.
It's not much of a step. From this to this, is it?
Oh, really, Inspector? Do I impress you as a kind of man who would play with dolls?
Somebody isn't playing.
Mary, you look lovely.
It's Mary's day off. I'm Louise, remember?
Well, whoever you are, let's hurry, eh? Because we're going to be late.
A moment. I want to hear what Dr. Glenn has to say about Father. I'll be right down.
Oh, your father's ill again, is he?
He was complaining of chest pains again this afternoon. How is he, Doctor?
Difficult, as usual.
What does that mean?
No need for alarm. Your father will be around for many years yet if he looks after himself properly. Which I doubt. What are you giving him, sir?
Oh, Dr. Glenn, this is Donald Loftus.
Pleased to meet you.
Donald's a medical student.
No. Well, after 20 years as a physician, may I offer you some advice?
Yes, please do.
Take up plumbing. As it's Mary's night off, I'll leave this with you. Your father's to have 1/2 ounce at bedtime and the same again in the morning. I'll call in sometime tomorrow.
Oh, Doctor, Donald and I have planned to go out for dinner this evening.
Perfectly all right. Just make it plain to your father that all he needs is rest. Only wish I had someone to tell me the same thing.
Good night, Dr. Glynn. Thank you. He's a very good doctor. It's just that he doesn't have much of a bedside manner.
Hmm. You see, bedside manner, that's my strong point. Give me a chance to demonstrate.
No! I told Father we're leaving.
No. I don't want you to go out.
It's Donald you really object to, isn't it?
I suppose I do.
I'm sorry, Father. You'll just have to get used to him.
Why should I?
Because I'm going to marry him.
You're out of your mind.
You know I'll have to leave you sometime.
It's out of the question. I need you here.
Please, it's not going to happen tomorrow.
Didn't Dr. Glynn tell you that I need attention?
He assured me that all you need is rest.
And how much rest will I get with you careering around with...
Good night, Father. I won't be gone long.
Louise.
I'm sorry, Don. I guess I shouldn't have come.
Have you been talking to your father?
Don, would you be very upset if I asked you to put off our wedding? Just for a little while?
You have been talking to him, haven't you? What did he say?
I can't leave him now. You do understand, don't you?
Of course. He's a sick man. He needs you. That's what he's been telling you, isn't it? He's playing on your sympathies. He's using his illness as an excuse to keep you there. He's a selfish man.
Don, you've no right to say such things. He is my father.
That's just the point. He's your father. He's not your lover.
What do I owe the pleasure of this interruption?
Nadeau, the inspector came to see me today.
Yes, yes, he came to see me too.
What did he want to know?
He asked about you, Clermont, Saville.
And the commission?
Yes, he wanted to know about that also.
And did you tell him anything?
Just what he wanted to know.
But supposing he finds out about us and Saville?
Saville won't talk.
What makes you so sure?
I am sure.
Who's there? Who's there?
Don't you know?
Who are you?
Take a good look. Look.
Ilse von Sturm. Yes. After all these years.
Years can be cruel. But not as cruel as men.
What do you want?
What I've always wanted. Justice.
You're making a mistake, you know. Didn't Clamor tell you?
Clamor is dead.
But I had nothing to do with that.
You are lying.
It's the truth. I swear it.
Yes, you swear it. Just as you swore my life away more than 20 years ago. Did you think I could ever forget?
But that's all over now. That's ended.
Nothing ever ends, Mr. Seville. Nothing but life itself.
Get out of here before I call the police. You see, I'm ill. My heart is...
You never had a heart.
Out. Where did you go to?
I wanted some fresh air. I wheeled myself. Short day.
Where?
Just to see an old acquaintance.
Thank
hell is you?
Father, what's the matter?
I wasn't sure it was you.
Who else could it be?
I don't know.
Father, the front door was open when I came in.
Yes.
I found this parcel on the table in the hall. Was somebody here tonight?
Yes.
You're not well. You should be in bed.
Please sit down. I've got to talk to you.
Before you do anything else, you'll take some of this.
What is it?
It's the medicine Dr. Glynn left you.
Please listen to me, Louise.
Just as soon as you've taken this.
It's bitter.
It's good for you. Now then.
Louise.
Don't worry. I'll see who it is.
May I come in for a minute? Louise, I'm sorry. I had no right to speak to you that way.
I'm sorry, too.
I had to come back and apologize.
I'm glad you came back, Doc. It was awfully stupid.
When you arrived home, the door was wide open, and your father was upstairs. In other words, anybody can come into this house without your father knowing about it.
I've told you all I know.
It's what we don't know that's important. Look, can't you see she's upset? Do you have to ask her all these questions now? No, Mr. Loftus, we can ask you.
Why didn't you escort Miss Saville home this evening?
Because we had a misunderstanding about our wedding.
You are engaged?
We haven't told anyone yet.
Did your father know?
I couldn't tell him. Not in his condition.
But why not?
He didn't want me to get married. Not yet.
Miss Saville has told us it took her approximately 15 minutes to walk home. How long did it take you to drive the same distance, Mr. Loftus?
Perhaps 5 minutes. Why?
Well, I think it would be perfectly clear. Sergeant Morgan is suggesting that you could have driven over here and arrived 10 minutes before Miss Saville.
Only I didn't. I just drove around for a few minutes to cool off. Why are you asking all these questions? Mr. Saville died of a heart attack.
You're a medical student, aren't you?
That's right.
Well, I'm not. But I did recognize the smell from that bottle.
What are you talking about?
Mr. Saville, the medicine that you gave your father contained prussic acid.
Hydrocyanic acid, cyanide. I haven't heard the term prussic acid used in years.
Well, I'm not here to discuss terminology, Doctor.
I trust you're not here to accuse me of administering poison to my patients, either.
No one is accusing you of anything. Obviously, the medicine bottles were switched.
No fingerprints?
Gloves. I'm much more interested in what you may have prescribed for another patient of yours.
Another patient?
Mrs. von Sturm.
Surely you don't think that she had anything to do with what happened to Saville? She's a hopeless invalid.
Hopeless?
Figure of speech. But after all those years in a wheelchair...
What exactly is wrong with her, Doctor?
Hysterical paralysis.
Meaning?
Hysterical paralysis arises in the mind, but the effect is quite real. As long as her mental state persists, the paralysis exists.
What if she were pretending?
Now, come. Anyway, why should she pretend?
Why should a madman be mad?
So, because she was clever. Ben Saville, I know what you are thinking. I should be sorry, shouldn't I? No. I have waited too long. All these years I have waited. You do understand, don't you? I knew you would. And I'm a kinder. It's only justice, justice, justice!
Mother!
Yes?
I was just worried about you sitting in the dark like this.
What else is there for an old woman to do?
Well, you could try and live.
After what was done to me?
That was a long time ago. One can't go on living in the past. Suppose Clerma had got us another hearing and cleared our names. You and I could have started a new life. We could have reclaimed our estates and gone home.
This is our home.
We'd be free of this doll's house forever.
You're not happy here?
Happy? In this house? With nothing to see but dolls. No one to talk to. A person would have to be out of his mind.
Is that what you think has happened to me?
I'm sorry, Mother. Sorry. I didn't mean to.
I know, my late Blue. It's all right. I'm an old woman. This is the only life I know. Too late for me to begin again. But one thing I know. Those who harmed us will be brought to justice for their crimes. The evildoers will be punished.
Oh, Mr. Ledoux, but I'm just going out for me dinner.
Hello, Charlie. You have something of interest for me?
You know this place as well as I do. Just mark up what you want and I'll send it up your studio. Here.
Thank you. Good boy, Charlie.
I'll see you.
And so there was one. Ledoux.
None, sir.
Miss Saville, how long have you known Mr. Loftus?
5 weeks.
Only 5 weeks? And you're engaged already?
Well, Mr. Holloway, that's none of your affair, is it?
I suppose it would be time enough to discover that you would receive a comfortable inheritance when your father died.
What are you talking about?
Here is a list of your fiancé's outstanding bills. Car, wardrobe, other debts. In excess of £2,000.
You've been pretty busy, haven't you?
We've already established that you had access to the poison and that you could have switched the bottles.
Sure. But you're forgetting one thing, Mr. Holloway.
Inspector Holloway. But do go on.
Whoever killed Mr. Saville obviously killed the others. What possible motive would I have had for that?
What indeed? An impoverished medical student? A girl who works in a toy shop? If only you could speak.
Well, I think we've seen all we want to see. I'll get it driven away.
Well, I wish you would, Governor. It's cluttering the yard up.
Mrs. von Stern, how long does it take you to make a doll?
That depends. Some I merely dress. Others require much work. Look at this. You see, this is Hans, and here is Maria and Otto. I knew them all back in Germany, many years ago.
You also have memories of some others. Clermont, Saville, Ruth, Ledoux. Their dolls were also a likeness.
Anyone can make a likeness.
Yes, but not everybody has a motive. You had a very strong one.
Revenge? Why should I have waited 20 years for revenge? You're going out?
I was just going to work.
It's earlier than usual.
I have to stop off on the way there.
Ah, you are lying.
Why should I lie to you, Mother?
You are going to meet someone, hmm?
Well, why shouldn't I?
A girl?
What if it is?
What's she like?
Oh, she's...
She dark?
She's just, yeah. She's just someone I know. I must go. I'll be back first thing in the morning.
Some of the other shops that might have stocked the dolls, but they hadn't sold any to your mother.
Ah, and she only had the six that she bought from you. I've searched everywhere for them, and I can't find them.
Well?
Listen, Gina, will you do something for me?
What?
Get me four more of those dolls. You must have four in stock.
Why those dolls?
I can't tell you why. Just trust me.
Is that why you asked me out? Just to protect your mother?
Please, Gina. Please help me. My mother is a sick woman. I'm the only one who can protect her. I must have those dolls.
Stern, where's your son?
He went to work.
Well, perhaps he'll be able to help me.
Wait! He'll be home in the morning. You can talk to him then.
Yes, after you've already spoken to him. Good night, Mrs. Von Stern, and thank you.
Good night.
Mr. von Stern? Mr. von Stern?
Who is it?
Inspector Holloway.
Oh, Inspector, my apologies. I'm not used to visitors.
I'd like to talk to you for a few minutes, if I may.
Yes. Yes, of course. I was just finishing my rounds. You can come with me if you like.
Don't you find it a bit lonely here with nothing but boats for company?
No.
Oh.
I take it this isn't a social call, then?
No. I just want to find out more about your mother.
Well, I'll tell you what I can.
I understand how you feel about her. You want to protect her, don't you?
Yes. Yes, I do. She was the one who always protected me.
Dr. Glynn says that the reason for your mother's paralysis is not physical.
The reason doesn't matter. She's helpless.
I have to take care of her. Have to?
Well, I want to. This is my office, for what it's worth. Sit down, Inspector. There's something I must make clear to you. My mother is a harmless old woman. There's nothing in her life but dreams and dolls.
Some of those dreams are fantasies of revenge. Some of those dolls existed in real life.
Yes, but she's not responsible for anything.
Can you swear to me that she never leaves the house? Can you?
Interesting lot of books you have here. Abnormal psychology. From the look of that collection, you must be quite an expert on the subject.
It's a way of passing the time. That and my music. What else am I to do cooped up in here all on my own?
Look at pictures of girls, perhaps. Have you got a real girl, Mark?
No.
Thank you.
No!
What are you doing?
He's our enemy, Mother.
Give me the knife.
Mother, he's our enemy.
Give me the knife.
Mother.
You need to be afraid. I will protect you. Mark, look away. Mark, look out. Mark. Ah! Oh! Oh! Ah! Mama!
Yeah, they're on their coffee now, sir.
You stay here. Somebody's got to settle the bill. It's bound to be outrageous.
Inspector Holloway. Mm. Nice to see you. How's your head?
Oh, much better, thank you. It's only a mild concussion and a few bruises. However, it gave us a few days to do a bit of homework.
Well, we don't see you down here very often.
Well, on a policeman's pay, Mr. Loftus. I don't get down here very often.
Well, will you join an impoverished medical student for a cup of coffee?
Thank you. Hello, Miss Saville.
Tell me, is there any news of Mark von Sturm?
No, he's disappeared completely.
And his mother doesn't know where he is?
So she claims.
Surely you're not taking her word for it.
The house has been searched from top to bottom. The place has been watched continually ever since I was found with this dent in my head. Nobody has been in or out, except the tradesman.
But why did he attack you?
He went for me when I mentioned his mother. Maybe he thought he was protecting her. But if Mrs. von Sturm is the murderer, why now, of all times?
What do you mean?
I spoke to the German branch of Interpol. This morning, they've been checking up on the background of the von Sturm case. Apparently, the Allied High Commission issued a new report 2 weeks ago. It was sent to the von Sturms immediately. It clears von Sturm and restores his estates to his family. It also finds that the original members of the commission gave false evidence. They were all implicated. Klerber, Roth, Ledoux, and I'm afraid your father.
And Mrs. von Sturm was right.
Miss Saville, if your father was guilty, he's already paid the price. I don't think you'll find that you owe the von Sturms a thing.
Miss Saville. Sit down where we can be comfortable. You like my dolls? I can see that they like you. You work in a toy shop, don't you?
Yes.
Have you anything
like this?
It's marvelous.
Thank you. But you didn't come here to look at dolls.
You said you had something to show me. High commission.
Do you want to know what it says?
I already know.
My husband's case was... Oh, excuse me. My dolls, they needed some attention. My husband's case was reopened. His name was cleared. They found that the original members of the commission, including your father, had given false evidence.
But why are you giving this to me?
Because it proves that my son had nothing to do with the murders. Why should he want to kill anyone when our name is clear and our estate has been restored? You can give this to the police.
But why not give it to the police yourself?
I want nothing more to do with them. Coming here day after day, searching the house, asking questions. I don't trust them. That's why I called you.
But Mrs. von Stern, the postmark on this envelope is dated 2 weeks ago.
Please. I have given you proof of my son's innocence. Now you must go.
Why didn't you say something about this report 2 weeks ago? Perhaps you didn't know about it then. Perhaps Mark got the report when it arrived. But he never showed it to you. He hid it somewhere and you didn't find it until today.
I won't listen to your lies.
Then listen to the truth. When Mark got this report, he realized you would never go back to Germany and claim the estate. So he decided to take it all for himself. That you were in his way. So he committed a series of murders that only you could have a motive for. And left evidence to point to you as the murderer. He made those dolls. And killed those people in order to rid himself of you.
No! No! No!
Your son is a murderer. You can't protect him.
He is my son.
Can't you see? It's no use. They're bound to find him sooner or later. You must give him up. Where is he?
Come with me. He needs help.
What's in here?
Just a room. Sometimes when the children are naughty, I make them go in there to punish them. I found this hidden in Mark's room when I found the letters. He meant to kill you, too. Please. Be careful. The stairs are steep. No one but me. He's mine now. No one will take him away.
Thank you for your help, Miss Allen. I think you might realize now just how little you owe the von Stone family.
Mama. 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 Mama.